See here, in case of SAP, when we are going for an SAP implementation project, first of all, we need to understand their complete requirement.
Okay.
That is the company, say for example, now what we are planning to do is, we are planning to say we are a team of consultants. We are going to implement SAP for say Dr. Reddy Labs group. So Dr. Reddy Labs is a multinational company and their head office is in India, and in different countries they do have their business, right? So in case if we are going to implement SAP to this, right, how we have to do? And so everything before we go for SAP implementation, as per the SAP methodology I told you yesterday, right? So first of all, we need to understand the requirement. So as a team of consultants, we need to go and we need to discuss with the respective manager. FICO consultants will discuss with the finance manager, right, finance department, and the end users, that is business process owners. And MM, SD, PP, like that, each and every consultant, right, the group of consultants will go and discuss with the respective department. That is for the purpose of understanding their business process requirement. What is that has been running for the existing organization and how they want in future, because we are going to prepare as it is the existing organization structure in as is document, and we are going to prepare a blueprint. Once we prepare the blueprint, then we will configure the SAP system. So for that purpose, right, let us imagine that we are going for SAP implementation for a Dr. Reddy Labs group. Dr. Reddy Labs group, so right, so they have say around any number of computer codes they can have. So first of all, imagine that we have Dr. Reddy Labs group, and implementation has been done for Dr. Reddy Labs. This is DRL, B means bulk drugs. Under that group, we have Dr. Reddy Labs pharma, bulk drugs pharma, like that. And these two companies are, say for example, this is in India. We can create any number of companies under the group. So the total group is called company in case of SAP, right? The group, what are the group company? We call it as SAP, sorry, company. Under the group, any number of companies, right, as per the legal requirement, that is nothing but a registered legal entity, we call it as company code, right? So the companies under the group, we call it as company code. So the company codes is nothing but a registered legal entity as per the Companies Act of any country it may be, right? So that should be defined as company code. So this is the group company and the company code. And wherever you are doing your business, right, maybe we can call it as business area, right? Here it is in Hyderabad, and they have their plant in Shamirpet. Okay, we can define it as a plant now for the time being, because see, really the plant organization object is going to be defined by production planning consultants. But we are going to define it as a, okay, one of the business areas, because I want to capture expenses by business area wise, right? And Bangalore, Chennai, like that, in different places we do have business areas. And the concept of business area, I think slowly it is getting obsolete, but it is going to take place. Its place is going to be occupied by the profit center accounting, right? When we go to controlling, we are going to see in depth the profit center accounting part. But until then, let us understand the business area, right? It is not completely removed, right? It is there. We can use it business area, right? So this is called, we can call it as organization structure. And any number of company codes we can have under one group. Even let it be 100 company codes under the group, we can create one chart of account. What is chart of accounts? Chart of accounts is nothing but a chart wherein all the GL accounts are going to be defined. Whatever the GL account that are required for the companies to prepare their financial statements, like profit and loss account and balance sheet, we are going to define a chart of accounts. Let any number of company codes, we can do with one chart of accounts, because subsequently we are going to consolidate the total balance sheet, P&L account, etc. In order to consolidate, I'm going to have, if it is one chart of accounts, that will be easy for me. Though the company codes are in different countries, see, ultimately when you see the balance sheet and P&L account of any company, right, you will find balance sheet, assets, liabilities, income and expenditure in the P&L account. And liabilities, say share capital, secured loans, unsecured loans, reserves and surplus, like that everywhere, worldwide same. Similarly, assets, fixed assets, current assets, miscellaneous assets and investments, like that you'll have the assets. So ultimately the GL accounts are going to be used by any number of companies will be same. And here in SAP we are going to create GL accounts not only just by names, we are going to create with numbering system, right? How to create all those things we'll see anyway. Now before we go for SAP implementation, right, we need to understand their requirement, specification, that is language, English, accounting system as per Indian accounting standards, financial year, right, April to March or January to December, whatever it may be, you can define currency, INR, that is the company code currency. And we are going to have around 21 steps are there, basic steps which we need to discuss. Right, we need to create in SAP system itself. If you want to post any accounting entries in one company, right, we need to create first all these steps. All these steps means because
I need to. Hello.
Yeah.
Just I need one quick review on that. As you said, there will be a group of consultants for going for this implementation. Mm-hmm. So only the FICO person will be defining the company code and all those things.
No, yeah, you are right. See, whatever we are going to do now, we are learning from the FI CO perspective only. Okay. Right. So these are the things has to be done by FI CO consultant.
Okay.
So we are going to define all these steps. And so step number one, define company. Step number two, define company code. Right? These are the company code. Step number three, assign company code to company. Nothing but group company and the company are going to be established a link between these two. Otherwise, system cannot understand which company code belongs to which group.
Okay.
Right. And then create business area. Right. First four steps belong to organization structure of the company. Then next four steps belong to the general ledger accounting. Define chart of accounts. See here, with my name DRCA, I'll be using it. Then assign chart of accounts to company code. Once we create a chart of accounts, we'll link up company code to the chart of accounts so that any number of GL accounts, whatever you are going to create, that are going to be defined in the chart of accounts. And these chart of accounts are going to be used by these company codes, right? And logically, the chart of accounts is above the company code. That means organization structure, chart of accounts is at higher level. Right, so that any number of company codes can be linked to one chart of accounts. Any number of company codes can be linked to one chart of accounts. And define account group. So in chart of accounts, we are going to define account group. The account group will be consisting of, right, liabilities, assets, income and expenditure. Here liabilities, share capital, reserves and surplus. So the total GL accounts are going to be grouped. Right, grouped into, depending upon the nature of the accounts. And these groups we are going to define into the SAP system. How do it? We'll see anyhow. Right, just we'll, whatever we are going to configure here, whatever we decide, as per the requirement of the client, we are going to create same account groups in the SAP system.
Okay.
And, then coming to the account group, then define retained earnings account. So define retained earnings account means we need to define the retained earnings account. That is, so where you are going to post your the retained earnings, that is the profit that is going to be earned by the company after incurring all expenses and after transferring the profit and loss account, that is profit to the dividend, other results, whatever is amount that is going to be retained in the P&L account, that will be transferred to the retained earnings account. That we'll see. We define one account, that is a requirement in SAP to define retained earnings account, and we have to tell to the system to which account we are going to post, because that is going to be used for balance carry forwards, etc. Then coming to define fiscal year variant. Fiscal year variant means nothing but the financial year. So what is the financial year we are going to use, whether January to December or April to March? What is that? So that need to be first we need to define. See, first of all, any number of fiscal years, it may be January to December or April to March, everything is defined and kept in the system. Just we need to link up that fiscal year to the company code, right? So V3, it is called variant. V3 is equal to nothing but April to March. K4, January to December. Say now presently the current year is going to be, it is starting from 1/4/2013 to 31st March 2014. So that is 12 accounting periods, right? Here April, May, June, July, like that. Each month is called each period, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. Each account is, each month is called an each period. And so that we'll have 12 periods, right? These periods are called normal posting periods. Normal posting periods are nothing but for regular posting of entries. Apart from that normal posting periods, we have 4 more special periods. Special periods are nothing but for the purpose of finalization of accounts. That is, after March, as on 31st of March, I cannot prepare a balance sheet immediately, right? Because lot of provisional entries has to be done. I have to receive so many bills, right? Any person who participate in the finalization of accounts, then you'll come to know how time taking is the finalization of accounts. So for that purpose, what SAP has done, since I cannot prepare my balance sheet and P&L account, that is financial statements, immediately after completion of my financial year, right? It may take a month or two. Anyway, system has given 4 months. Within 4 months, I have to complete my finalization of accounts. Afterwards, periods will get closed. So that's why maybe even if when you are using SAP, hardly we require only 10 to 15 days. But of course, accounting process may take some more time, because getting the bills, etc. Okay. Right, so that's why 4 periods will be given, that is called special posting periods. Special posting periods are nothing but used for the purpose of finalization of accounts. Because after completion of my March, right, I'll be I have to prepare my balance sheet and P&L account. That may take around 15 days. Afterwards, internal auditors will come, they'll verify, they may suggest some more changes. And after that, statutory auditors will come. They may be suggesting us some more changes, whatever it may be, right? We are going to special posting periods will be used for the purpose of finalization of accounts. If it is going to be January to December, same process, right? January to December, 12 posting periods, and this is called normal posting periods. And special periods are nothing but for the purpose of finalization of accounts. Now January to December and January, February, March, April, 4 periods are given for the purpose of finalization of accounts. Right? And here, so here this is called defined fiscal year variant and assigned fiscal year variant. Though I say that defined fiscal year variant, we need not define any fiscal year variant. V3 is already defined and kept in the system. We need to link up that V3 to the company code. So to this company code, we need to link up so that system understands this company code is going to follow April to March, and this company code is going to follow maybe January to December, like that. Whatever it may be, we want, we can assign that particular fiscal year variant. Then coming to, right, say for example, now step number 11, 12, 13, they are nothing but posting period variant. No, in fact, with these 3 periods, what we are going to do is, system will allow me to post accounting entries only in the current month. Generally, that is the requirement. Every company will allow the users to post accounting entries only in the current month only. So for that purpose, what we do, we keep current month open, all rest of the months will be closed, because I am not supposed to post any accounting entries in the past, because that finalization of that monthly finalization has already been done. I cannot change that. Similarly, in future, right, future post dated entries should not be posted. because that is not going to be affected in the current one. Say anyway, cash and bank. Anyway, the purpose of posting future dated entries is not required at all. So that's why
what
only
is
current
the, kind of post-dated checks if I have to enter.
See, post-dated checks, when it is going to be affected?
In the future date.
Future
but
date.
I made the entries now.
Now, see, when you receive post-dated check, it is better, not only better, most of the cases people do, right, keep the check with you because you are unable to deposit the post-dated check now. Right. Keep the checks with the accounts department and on the date, pick up the check, post the date on the particular date.
What if the outward check?
Right. Even whatever it may be, outward check also, you are not supposed to. If you want to give, you can give it. With post-dated checks, we have a facility. With post-dated check only, with today's date, I can enter and the date of posting, I can give it. But it will not affect.
Okay.
Isn't it? Unless the date comes, it will not be affected.
Yeah, right.
I can issue in post-dated checks, nothing wrong. So that's why if it is generally current period is kept open. With today's date, I'll be posting. Posting date should be future date. But the date of entry is going to be today. So anyhow, that can be that. Just give me a second. 1 minute. So this posting period variant, that is closing or opening, so that will be done in three steps. How we'd work out, right, we'll see in the SAP system. So define posting period variant, assign posting period variant to company code, define open or close posting period. So here what we do, we'll keep only current month open, all rest of the months will be closed. And then coming to the step number 14 and 15, define field status variant and assign field status variant to company code. So 14 and 15 are interlinked to each other. Say for example here, say I am posting an accounting entry, telephone expenses account data to bank, right? So document number we are posting, right, on a particular date. Once you post the accounting entry, what I can do, being telephone expenses paid for the month of April. This is the text and this telephone expenses. Okay, up to here, this is sufficient in fact, right? This is sufficient. Telephone expenses to bank being telephone expenses paid. But the management wants after the month end, I want to know to which business area this belongs because I have different business areas here. Hyderabad, Shamirpet, Bangalore, Chennai. So if you post an accounting entry, right, telephone expenses account data to bank, that will be posted in the general ledger. But at the month end, I want to know to which business area this belongs, right? So I cannot get it. That's why SAP has given one specific requirement, facility rather, right? You can post expenses by business area wise. Business area wise, I can post business area Hyderabad. Similarly, maybe cost center, right? Once we create controlling area and cost accounting is also activated. So we can post business area Hyderabad, say cost center belongs to admin department or finance department, right, or any other department. So business area, this one. Like this, any fields, whatever you want, right, you can activate that field and post the accounting entry. So we have a facility like that. There are three options. One is suppress, another one is required, third one is optional. If you suppress, say for example, for telephone expenses, I don't require quantity field. So I'll suppress this. Once I suppress this, right, even that field will not be visible to the user at the time of accounting entry. Then if I make it required entry, Right, there'll be a symbol, not star of course, there'll be a right symbol will be there, right, that will come, and unless that is entered, that field is filled by the user, system will not allow him to save it. And if it is optional, right, field will be visible, and whether you enter it or not, least bothered. If you enter, you'll get the information. If you don't enter, you don't get the information. But if you make it required, definitely user has to enter the data. Enter the data that to the relevant data, not any other relevant data he has to enter. So then only system will accept. Relevant data means, say for example, business area. Business areas, whatever you have defined, out of that any one you have to enter. Of course, even if you enter each of Hyderabad, if you enter Bangalore, system takes. But ultimately that come to the that respective user's head, why you have entered a wrong entry. Right, but system will allow only business areas, whatever that have been defined. So at the time of capturing the information itself, we have to bifurcate the information, business area, cost centers, right, all these things has to be done. So that facility SAP has given. So anyhow, there are so many fields will be there, right, we call it as, right, say for example, around field status groups will be there, G001, G002, 3, 4 like that, so many groups will be there. Each group of field status will be used for different purposes, because for general ledger accounting, one group, for material accounting, one group, for bank accounting, one group. What are these groups? Each group will be consisting of so many fields, whether it is the required entry or mandatory or suppress. Depending upon the required fields for that particular account, we can use. So that we'll see anyhow afterwards. Right, in the system, we'll define field status variant and that we'll post it. So once defined field status variant, then assign field status variant to company code. So whatever the fields that you make it mandatory or optional or suppressed, what are the options that you choose, right, that will be defined in the group G001, 2, 3 like that, right, groups will be defined. So that group we are going to link up to the respective GL account, so that all the features, whatever you choose, required, optional, suppressed, etc., those things will be applicable when you go for the posting of entries. So how that will work out, right, we'll see anyhow while creating the field status group. That is 14 and 15. Then coming to 16, define document types and number ranges. So here, say this is a document. Each and every accounting entry, we call it as a document, right? It will give you document numbers, and that to each document, we have a name for that. SAP has defined standard documents, like SA is nothing but GL document. And here, say for example, customer invoice. Customer invoice, we call it as DR. Then customer payment, we call it as DZ. All these are all standard documents provided by SAP. The abbreviations, there is no full form for this, of course. Right, SA, GL document. DR, customer invoice. DZ, customer payment. DG, customer credit note. Like that, whatever the type of document that you are going to use, every document has been defined in the SAP system. We need not define. Though I say that define document type and number ranges, I need to choose which document I am going to use, and for that document I need to give the number range, maybe say 1 to 1 lakh. Then system, because see, even in case of manual system, when you are creating a document, we'll give document number 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Even in SAP, whatever the document that you are going to post, I want some number range to the document, because each document should be identified separately. So that's why we give document number and a range will be given. If I say 1 to 1 lakh is given to SA document, then system will post accounting entries like 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Up to 1 lakh, system will go on posting the accounting entries. That it'll take that number. right? That is called document type and number ranges. How we do it, we'll go to the system and we'll see. Define tolerance groups for employees. Define tolerance group for employees. What does this mean? So here this is nothing but right. Define tolerance group means amount authorization limits. How much system will tolerate? Say for example, one accounts officer is there, AO or AE, accounts executive. He'll be given authorization up to only 5 lakhs. AO. Any number of AOs as a blanket approval. AOs can pay up to vendor bills payment up to 5 that is 5 lakhs. Similarly, AFM, Assistant Finance Manager, 10 lakhs. Finance Manager, 25 lakhs. General Manager Finance, 50 lakhs. Anything above 50 lakhs should be approved by my MD. Here, approval means not physical documental approval. And here, every user will be given authorization. And in case if this person cannot do, that he will create and keep it. And it will be approved by either FM or AFM or whoever it may be, then only system will allow him to save it. Right? So that process, how it works out, we'll see later. Then coming to define tax procedure. Define tax procedure, assign tax procedure, they are linked to each other. In case of SAP, right, system is so transparent that whatever the entry that you are posting, whether it is applicable, sales tax, income tax, etc., system will look into it. So that's why in the beginning at this juncture, we are not going to define any sales tax or income tax or tax rates, everything. So those things will create when we go to the accounts receivable and accounts payable. But at this juncture, we are going to create one small tax procedure, and with that procedure, we'll go ahead. So that procedure will be assigned to the assigned tax procedure to the country. So first of all, we define a tax procedure that will be linked to the country, because generally tax procedures are at country level, whether you take income tax, central excise, so whatever it may be, right, that will be linked to the respective country. Then last and final step, define global parameters. So whatever the things that we have defined here, all those things will be visible in one screen, right? Global parameters. There will be some three check boxes will be there. Those check boxes that we'll tick it. And what are those and what is the use of that, we'll see in the system itself, right? So these are the 21 steps that we have to define. Let us go ahead with the definition when defining the same in the SAP system. So first of all, you'll have your SAP logon icon on your desktop or laptop. You can freely download it, right? Manoj, I think since you are new, yeah. Right, you can in Google, you can say SAP GUI download, right? Just you type, okay. You'll get it. You can download. It takes around 320 MB.
Yeah.
Right, once you install that, this icon okay. will come. Right, once okay. Your service provider, right, through whom you are coming, I think you are coming through Mr. Jairam. Right, you ask him, he'll provide you the what you call the server, but it takes, of course, not immediately, right? Maybe tomorrow or after tomorrow you can get it, right?
Okay.
Now this one, once you double click on that, this is called SAP logon pad. This logon pad, whatever the server that you are going to configure, that will appear here, right? Just double click on that server name. And SAP, I'm using HP5. Mr. Prasad, what is the version you are using?
Yes.
What is the version you are using
now?
HP5. HP5. Okay, right. That is the latest
EHP5.
Version.
HP5. Okay. Yes.
Good. Right.
And also one more thing, you are recording, right?
I'm recording.
Okay. That's fine. Then.
So one more thing I need to ask. We'll be working on different servers, or how will I be assessed?
See, not different servers. One server will be given access to you. There, whatever I'm going to teach you, you configure on your own. Right, I'll be giving you this recorded version as well as the document, everything. Right, configuration document is going to be given.
Okay, will you be verifying that configurations?
Huh?
Will you be verifying those configuration if I have done it right or not?
On your own, you can verify. Once you are able to post accounting entry, that is correct. If your system says an error, then there is a mistake. And you have to follow that error message, whatever system is going to give you, you have to rectify it. Right? If you have any doubts, you can ask me again, of course.
Okay.
Right. And here, so as soon as you enter, SAP Easy Access screen.
Okay.
Just give me a second one here.
Hello.
Yeah, 1 minute. Just I'm searching for one. Okay. Okay. So once you open up this one, right, SAP Easy Access screen is visible here. You can close this one once you open it. This is the easy access screen.
No, I don't see that. I'm seeing the Excel sheet.
No?
Yeah, now I can see.
Yeah. So, easy access screen, you can see like this. 1 minute. Okay. So, in the easy access screen, you'll find this is called menu path. This is enter, right? Enter, if you keep the cursor, enter here. The same button, the way how you press enter in our keyboard, same enter. This is called command box, right? This is called a standard toolbar. Standard toolbar is nothing but, right, the standard for every screen, it will be appearing. This is the title bar, and this is called transaction toolbar. Depending upon the nature of the transaction, this will change. Okay, now this is called body of the screen, and this is a menu, SAP menu. And here you can drill down financial accounting, general ledger, like this. We can drill down. Yeah, I think if you drill down everything, it will go down a kilometer down, right? Almost it might go to 1 kilometer, that much length. Okay, anyhow. Now we are going to, first of all, as a consultant, we are going to configure, right, in IMG screen. See, this is called Easy Access screen. There are two things. One is IMG screen, another one is Easy Access screen. As soon as you enter, you can see this Easy Access screen. So this is going to be used, right, used by the end users. The purpose is creation of master records and creation of reports, entering day-to-day transactions. For this purpose, we use this easy access screen.
Okay.
Now, as a consultant, first what we need to do, I need to go to IMG screen, and this will be used by the consultants, not by
what
the IMG
screen.
IMG screen means implementation guide.
Okay.
Right. The purpose is configuration of system and customization of reports. Everything is done by consultant. So, as a consultant, we need to configure the system here and come to Easy Access screen for the purpose of testing. So, configure here, test it whether it is working fine or not.
Okay.
Right. So, that's why now we are in Easy Access screen. In order to move to that IMG screen, I need to use T-code SPRO. So, generally for T-codes, you will not have any
what
expansion.
T-code?
Yeah, I'll tell you. Transaction code. a transaction code will be there, a code will be there that we call it as transaction code. Transaction code generally it will not have any expansion, they are not abbreviations. But okay. Only one SPRO can have the expansion, that is SAP project reference object, right? Okay. This is the only SPRO you have that this one. Rest of the things, yeah, there will be so many codes, FS00, F-02, like that some codes will be there. They are just code numbers, that's all. It will not have any expansion. But only SPRO will have SAP project reference object. And what we have to do, you have to go to command box. Here, you can type SPRO. It is not case sensitive. You can use either capital letters or small letters, anything. Type SPRO here, press enter.
Okay.
Then click on SAP reference IMG. Then you'll come to this IMG screen, right? Implementation guide. See here, say SAP customizing implementation guide. Here you'll have enterprise structure, right? For financial accounting, controlling, right? For all consultants, they have to launch. This is their launching pad. Here your playground, you start playing the game. Now, right, now see whatever the configuration step that we have to create, right, DRCA, DRLB, right, the group company, company and GL accounts, business areas, everything we have to define first. Because unless you define all these things, you cannot post an accounting entry. Right, when I am going to post an accounting entry, I need GL account, I need business area, I need the text field. All these things are required here. Right, so that's why let us first create. So step number one, define organization structure. In this, define company, right? The topmost one, define company. So in order to create that company, there is right side arrow here, click on that. Enterprise structure, we are going to define organization structure or enterprise structure, right? Go to enterprise structure and definition, financial accounting, define company. And I told you every screen will have a transaction code. In order to activate the transaction code, click on additional information, display IMG, IMG activity. This is the path. Click on this. The last four digits will form part of the transaction code. The purpose of transaction code I'll tell you later. First of all, I want to define my company. See here, you can see IMG document, IMG activity documentation, right? Read all this documentation, that is very much important. It will give you a clear understanding of the subject. Maybe in the beginning, you may feel it a bit difficult to understand the slang, the language, new jargon, new terminology. But as you go on reading, you'll get accustomed to that. But understanding and reading of this document is very, very important, right? So define company, and this is called IMG activity. Here I need to define. Now click on this IMG activity button, that clock like button.
Okay.
Right here I have given you 1 minute. So here I have given you the notes, everything in this notes. Advantages of SAP, see project, etc. How many days it will take? Right, how to log into SAP system. So double click on SAP, everything has been provided to you here. Right here, I have given the path for the first step. For every step it is given, right, define basic configuration settings. Define company, right, SPRO, SAP reference IMG, enterprise structure, definition, financial accounting, right, define company. The T code is OX15. right? So at the end, whenever you come to the end here, click on this button. Here already SAP has defined when you are buying this SAP, it is in 800 client, right? They will give you all the sample companies. So many sample companies will be given to you.
What is this 800 client means? I didn't understand that.
So this is 800 client is nothing but this is the SAP IDES version, we call it as the number that is given to the this training system, that is called 800 number.
Okay.
See, okay. I'll show you. As soon as you log into the system, double click on this client number 800.
Okay, what did that mean?
That is number given to this SAP system, because in a landscape, that means in an SAP system, you will have around maybe half dozen SAP clients, right? The purpose of that everything I'll discuss later. At this juncture, understand a client number 800. This is for the purpose of getting training, we use it.
Okay.
Give me a second. I think one more person joined. Right. Okay, so define company. So here sample data will be available, but of course we don't require this sample data for the time being. Right, let us create our own. So here I am going to create one, say company code, Dr. Reddy Labs. So I'll take say DRL group. You can create DRL group. Dr. Reddy Labs groups. Right, street, say Banjara Hills. PO box number. Right, city, Hyderabad. Country. Here, when you come to the country, right, here standard countries are available here in the system. You select. All countries are available here. Right, all countries are available here. So from this you can choose country India. GHI India. Double click on this. Or you can type IN. Similarly, languages. Right, so languages, I want English. Sorry, this is we are in language key. Achha. I want to show you how many countries are there. Around 235 countries are available. Right, you can choose anything from here. Yeah. then language key English, you can use EN. Then coming to currency, right, our currency is INR. See how many currencies are there, 218 currencies are there, right? Out of that we can choose INR, or straight away you can type INR. So like this we can create a company like this. Once you enter all these things, click on save. Alright, so of course this I have already just created, that's why I cannot create immediately like this. I'll take it as right, you can save it. So once you save, system will give you one number. This is called request number. Request number, this is going to be used for the purpose of transporting the total configuration from one system to another system, because we are going to use around more than half a dozen systems in a landscape, right? Those details I'll tell you later, right? It is too early for you to understand, right? You'll be getting into a bit confusion. That's called server landscape. I'll explain you about the server landscape at a later stage.
Okay.
We'll create. So just I have taken only one letter out. I have saved it, but anyway the company code whatever you are going to use is Dr. Reddy Labs Group, right? Pharmaceutical company.
Yeah.
I'll delete this one because we'll be going ahead with that. Right, so DRL GRP is our company. So like this, this is a pharmaceutical company. Come back. Next, step number two. Define company code. Define company code. So my company code is going to be here. Edit, copy, delete, check company code. Here I have to use it. Just give me a second. Okay, right, define company is over. Step number two, define company code. Edit, copy, delete, check company code. So don't forget to read the documentation here. It will give you a very clear understanding of the subject. Right, click on this. When you click, edit company code data. Click on edit company code data. Go to new entries. So I'm going to create my own company code. So I'm taking DRLB, Dr. Reddy Labs Bulk Drug. Right, Bulk Drugs Limited. City, where it is in Hyderabad. I'm taking Hyderabad. Country, India, IN. Currency, INR. Language, I'm going to use English. Right, all these things I need to tell to the system. Once you enter these things, we have to save it. Right, so once you save, just I have not, because I've already created, that's why I'm not saving it. DRLB, right. See, it will be available like this. Dr. Reddy Labs Bulk Drugs Limited. Hyderabad, India, right? Then click on this button, or just you save, it will open up. Dr. Reddy Lab Bulk Drugs Limited, and DRLB. DRLB is nothing but my company code. Address you can give, just press enter. Right. So once you do this, click on save. Whenever you save anything, system will create a request number like this. Right. This will be used for the purpose of transporting from one server to another server. Right. So like this, we need to go ahead with the total configuration steps. Then coming to step number three. Step number three is nothing but assign company code to company. Assign company code to company. What does it mean? So
how
whatever
do I create a subsidiary from this?
No, it is not subsidiary. Right. For the time being, we are creating only group company, that's all. Subsidiary companies we have to define. There is other method that is too early for us to understand now.
No, we have created a company code.
We have created a company
code. That is a subsidiary company of the group, right?
Group that I'm that we have created. We are going to link up now. I'll show you now.
Okay.
Right, so close this one. Enterprise structure, assignment, financial accounting, assign company code to company. Here I need to go ahead, select our company, company code, right? The company code is, say for example, DRLB, right? Against DRLB, right, this DRLB belongs to Dr. Reddy Labs group. Select your group. Dr. Reddy Labs group, DRL group. Double click on that, or manually you can enter it. Right, then save it. So now both are linked to each other.
Okay.
Right? So yeah. Group company and company code are linked to each other. So this is the subsidiary. So I cannot say subsidiary.
Yeah. Right.
This is cannot be a subsidiary, because subsidiary means, right, the percentage, you know, right, maybe 90 plus percentage has to be held by one company. So certain conditions are there. So what we have done is now we have created the company under the group.
Okay.
Uh-huh. 1 minute. So Jairam. Hello, Mr. Jairam. Hello. Okay, so like that we have to create group company, company, and linking up, right?
Okay.
So today, so as a sample, how to enter into the SAP system, right, all those things we have seen, right? Tomorrow actually We'll go ahead with the total configuration. From tomorrow onwards, we'll go ahead with that. Okay. Posting of creation of all these 20 steps, everything will go ahead.
Okay.
Right. So yeah. Devi Prasad.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Hi.
So hope I think you are able to follow.
Yes, Anna.
Right, because you are already
fine
user. Yeah. Okay. So like this, the total 20 steps, right? We'll do it like that.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
So just only.
Tomorrow what time?
Tomorrow I'll let you know exact time. I think for the time being, imagine that is only 9:30 to 10:45 like that.
Okay.
If there is any change, I'll let you know.
Okay. One more thing in this, the topic what we covered,
yeah.
You have written SPR or something to get that IMG screen.
Correct.
So do you have a way, means you have to remember all these codes or you have a menu where you can select
here
that?
Menu is there, right, and also I have given all the transaction codes here, right. Over a period of time you may be remembering this.
Okay.
Right.
Now how do I get that SPRO first instead of typing that?
See here. Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, hello?
Can you hear me?
Is this Mr. Ethan?
Yes, this is Rakesh.
Rakesh, just be in line for a moment, right? I'll talk to you.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can hear me.
Okay, right. And, yeah. So here,
which
SPRO, I can create it in favorites, right? I'll tell you how to create this one. I can type here SPRO directly and we can go ahead, or we can create a favorites and keep it ready, right?
Okay, what about the menu? It is not available in the menu.
No, it is available, of course, down the stairs it is available. Instead of that, let us type SPRO here and go ahead. That will be easy.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll continue again tomorrow, right? So if anything change is there, I'll let you know. Okay. So 9:30 to around 10:45 or 11 o'clock, we'll have 1.5 hour session we'll have tomorrow.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay then. Take care. We'll meet tomorrow then. Bye.
Yeah. Thank you.
If anything is there, you can send me mail, Mr. Prasad. And yes. Manoj, right? Anything is there, you can send me mail or you can talk to me.
Okay, right.
Right then, bye.
Thank you, bye.
Yeah, Mr. Rakesh?
Yes, is it fine?
Rakesh, I think your mic unable to see, it is not switched on. How you are speaking?
Speaking, dialing from my cell phone.
Okay, right. You can rather select the mic and speakers here so that you can listen from your laptop.
It is on, so let's see here.
See what you have done, you have selected other option, I think.
Yeah. So how do I enable mic on my, because my speakers are on my laptop.
See here, there is a telephone, mic and speakers. That option, in the audio, there is an option called audio.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Click that
one. I did that.
Click that one, right? On that, if you click on mic and speakers.
Online meeting.